Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss about endometrium. What is a normal endometrium? How does it look on the histology? And about the endometrial hyperplasia. In this image is a histological image. You can see three different layers of the uterus. This layer is a perimetrium or serosa. This layer is a myometrium, and my friends, this thing here is a endometrium. So the endometrium is a inner layer of uterus. Endometrium does not mean epithelium. Many students or many people still understand that the endometrium is just nothing but an epithelium. No, it's not. Endometrium is much more than just an epithelium. Okay, so if you see the slide of a normal endometrium, and if you want to identify different structures into that, you need to concentrate on this image. As you see here, this thing is a gland. This is a particular endometrium glands. So normal appearance is a sawtooth glands. This thing, if you are seeing here in pink color, is a secretion in the gland. What is a secretion? The glycogen rich secretion is there. Now this is a stroma. All this thing is stroma around the glands. You need to see this thing is a stroma surrounding the glands. Okay, and some arterioles, spinal arterioles, can be also seen. So what you are seeing in this image is a glands surrounded by stroma with less cells. See here, you cannot see much cells here. The stroma is actually a very is not very full of cells. Okay, now if you particularly concentrate on particular gland here, so this is a just one gland here. You can see here, this is the columnar epithelium. See, the gland is lined by columnar epithelium, which is normal endothelium. Okay, now you need to see one ratio here, gland stroma ratio or GS ratio. GS ratio is, you see here is a normal. Here is a normal GS ratio, here also a normal GS ratio. And if you want to see a normal slide of endometrium, then this is the slide of endometrium. You can see here, this is a one gland surrounded by stroma. Okay, now come to this point. In this thing, you have different glands here. This is the one gland, this is the another gland, this is the another gland, this is the gland, this is the gland, this is the gland. So what you are seeing here is a, this is a normal endometrium, and this is the endometrial hyperplasia. What you see here is there are much glands in this slide. The stroma has been decreased comparable to the glands. So GS ratio, gland to stroma ratio, is increased in endometrial hyperplasia. This thing is an endometrial carcinoma. We will discuss this thing later, but right now I want to make you the difference between normal endometrium and endometrial hyperplasia. What is endometrium, normal endometrium? The GS ratio is not that much. Here the GS ratio has been increased. The stroma is very less. And this stroma, if you see here, this one, it has too much of cells, where in this stroma there are less cells has been seen. Okay, now let's go further. This is a normal endometrium, suggestive of normalcy, and this is the thickened endometrium here. Okay, this is the proliferative endometrium. This is non-atypical hyperplasia. This is atypical hyperplasia. So now we want to know what is typical and what is non, what is atypical. Okay, see, when we see something very repeatedly and it's normal, we call it typical. But when we don't see a thing in normal routine, we call it atypical. So we are seeing here is a atypical cells. For example, this is a typical endometrial gland, typical, with columnar epithelium here, and this is a atypical cells you see here. The cells you see here is a atypical cells. Atypical cells have loss of normal orientation to the basement membrane. Here is the basement membrane. See, here is the basement membrane and these are the cells. This is typical cell. What is atypical? Typical means the cells have lost the polarity to the basal membrane with different kind of nucleuses. So this is atypical cells. Now let's talk about endometrium much more. As I have seen already, told already, that endometrium is not just an epithelium. It's a complete layer. It originates from mesoderm along with myometrium. So this is the myometrium. This is a basal endometrium. This is a functional endometrium. The endometrium has two basic layers, the basal endometrium and the functional endometrium. Basal endometrium is a static one. That means basal endometrium does not shed or does not regenerate. It stays there. While the functional endometrium is very responsive to estrogen and progesterones, it will keep regenerating and shedding according to the menstruation cycles. Only endometrial functionalis layer get sheds and lost and regenerate. Now we have already discussed that estrogen promotes division and growth. It will increase the size of endometrium. When I talk about the size of endometrium, I am talking about the thickness of endometrium. So this is the uterus and this is the inside endometrium. We are talking about this thickness. Okay. The progesterone makes glands. It does not promote growth of endometrium. Remember this thing. So this illusion of this illustrating figure here, this is the endometrium. Estrogen will increase the thickness of endometrium, while the progesterone does not increase the thickness. It only increases the glandular tissue here. This is a normal endometrium, this is glands. Now let's talk about the epithelium of endometrium. What is epithelium of endometrium? Is a tall columnar epithelium with microvilles. When I talk about epithelium of endometrium, that means the epithelium of endometrial glands basically. Okay, now let's talk about histology some more. Normal endometrium and endometrial hyperplasia. Normal endometrium I have already told you, and what is endometrial hyperplasia I have already told you. Big increased GS ratio. But there are two different kinds of endometrial hyperplasia, simple and complex. What is simple endometrial hyperplasia and what is complex endometrial hyperplasia? You need to identify the difference. In simple one, the GS ratio is increased but on limited amount, while in complex, the GS ratio is too much increased. You can see the mitosis on the pathology slide, which is much more in complex. Glands lined by columnar epithelium in simple one, but the glands are lined by stratified squamous epithelium in complex endometrial hyperplasia. First of all, I want to clear you that this thing you will not decide. this thing will be decided by the pathologist. Okay, the pathology people will see the slide and tell you in their report that which kind of endometrium is that. Is it endometrium hyperplasia? It is complex, it is simple, or like that. There are two different cells we have already discussed, the typical cells and atypical cells. So the typical cell, the difference between two cells you need to understand. But again, once I already told you that this thing will be decided by pathologist. You just need to see the endometrium. You just need to get the endometrial biopsy and send to the pathologist. The pathology people will see the slide and do the histopathological examination and gives you the report in which they will mention that whether there are atypical cells present or not. What are the atypical cells? They are increased in size. They have lost the polarity from the basal layer. This is a irregular shape, altered nuclear cytoplasmic or altered nuclear cytoplasmic ratio. Okay, so we have already discussed this thing here. Here is the hyperplasia, and here is the carcinoma you are seeing here. Here is the typical cell, here is a atypical cell. Okay, so this is basic thing I am trying to talk. Now, what are the symptoms of endometrial hyperplasia? It may be irregular bleeding, and in postmenopausal women, there will be bleeding after a successful menopause. As a gynecologist, what you do a transvaginal ultrasound. And you measure the endometrial thickness and you see the contour of the endometrium on ultrasound. This is, my friend, the picture of ultrasound. This is the uterus here. And this is the endometrium. You measure the thickness of endometrium. Okay. This is a secretory endometrium. This endometrium is a homogeneous. But in this endometrium, you can identify three different lines. That is triple line endometrium. Okay. Now, if the endometrial thickness is more than 12 mm in premenopausal patient and more than 5 mm in postmenopausal patient, then you need to go for endometrial biopsy, because you suspect endometrial hyperplasia. Endometrial biopsy will go to the pathologist and they will give you the report. And now your management will be dependent on that basic report. So my friends, pathology is very important. What is the management? If the endometrial hyperplasia is there and there is no atypical cells found, then it's low risk for developing into endometrial carcinoma. What is the risk? 1-3%. So this case can be managed conservatively. What do you give? You give a prolonged progesterone to this endometrium. What it will do? It will just progesteronize the endometrium, and once you withdraw the progesterone, this endometrium will be shed. So you get rid of that pathological endometrium. That's it. But if the ATPI is present, then the risk of developing endometrial carcinoma increasing drastically, like 8-30%, even 30%. So it's better to go for surgical option, hysterectomy. But if in case a patient does not want a hysterectomy, then you need to make a counseling with the patient that yes, you have a higher risk of developing endometrial carcinoma, and still if you want to preserve the uterus, you need to do a large or prolonged progesterone treatment and then shedding of endometrium. But even after that, this chance is there. So along with the patient discussion, you need to go for hysterectomy options. This was all about endometrial hyperplasia. Thank you.